जय गुरुदेव स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू हिस्ट्री लेसन 6, द अर्ली स्टेट्स. इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड हाफ द लेसन. जस्ट आई विल गिव यू द ब्रीफिंग. वी स्टडीड इन ऋग्वेद पीरियड आर्यंस ट्राइब्स स्प्रेड फ्रॉम नॉर्दर्न इंडियन फ्रॉम काबुल टू अपर गैंजेस. आर्यंस एंड नॉन आर्यंस टूगेदर गेव राइज टू इंडस स्टेट्स एंड आर्यन गेव राइज टू जना or tribe formed kula, that is families. These tribes gave birth to janpada. And now we will talk about the ashwamedha. A horse was let loose to roam freely and it was guarded by king's men, whoever stopped the horse had to fight with raja's men. And if it was let free, it is understood that they accepted Raja supremacy. The Raja was known as, once it if it is accepted, later the Raja got the title as Chakravarti Samrat. And the king which was let loose, the horse which was let loose, was known as Ashwamedha. These kings were Raja of Janpadas. After defeating smaller Janpadas, powerful states emerged known as Mahajanpadas. And there were total 16 Mahajanpadas. And Magadha was the most powerful Mahajanpada of all the 16. And apart from them, we have also studied that there were two types of states. One is monarchy, where hereditary rule used to take place. Hereditary rule means king's son only used to become the king. And the second type of state was republics, also known as Gana Sangha. And in this, powers were not with the in the form of hereditary, that is not in the hands of the Raja, but it was in the hands of the public. Powers were in the hand of the public in republic type of states. We have also studied about the social and economic life of the of these people, and the tax and the impositions of the taxes. Then we also studied about the Magadha in detail. Now we will continue with Magadha from page 51. Yes. After the Haryanyak dynasty, many kings emerged, but finally the Shishuhangas came to power. The Shishuhanga was overthrown by the Nandas. Means he was defeated by the Nandas. The Nandas ruled for almost 75 years, and the last Nanda ruler, Dhananda, who was very unpopular with the masses, was killed by Chandragupta Maurya, founder of the Maurya Empire. Means these Nandas, last king Dhananda, he was killed by Chandragupta Maurya, and this Chandragupta Maurya was the founder of the Mauryan Empire. What were the reasons that made Magadha so powerful and important? Now let us see the reasons why this Magadha was so important, and it was the best of the 16 Mahajanpadas, why it was so. The soil of the kingdom was fertile, yielding rich crops. It was made more fertile by the river Sun, which unites with Ganga near Patna. This also helped trade and transport. The first most important point about the Magadha was the soil. Soil was very fertile, and so because as soil was very fertile, they used to grow rich crops, and this why the soil was so fertile, because two rivers were united, that is river Ganga near Patna. and this helped the trade. Means because of this, trade was good, business was good, and the transport also was good. Magadha also had dense forest. These forests supplied wood for building houses, chariots, carts, and elephants for army and transport. Means because the soil was very fertile, they were rich, and the crop production was very good. So the automatic the business was very good. And then one more thing is because even water supply was very good. And because business was very good, even transport was very good. So these were the two reasons. And apart from them, they had dense forest in Magadha. There was forest was very thick. Through this forest, they used to get the wood, which is to supply through which they used to build houses, and chariots were built and carts were built. And because of this, transport also was very good. Besides these, Magadha had rich deposits of iron ore mines, which were used for making weapons and other important implements. So even iron ore was very good in Magadha, which was used to make weapons and other important implements. Thus we see that Magadha possessed certain advantages which were denied to other Mahajanpatas. So this is the main reason why Magadha was the best of all the 16 Janpatas, because it was having many facilities there and people used it properly, because of which it was a rich Magadha. Now let us study about the case study of Vajji. This is also one of the Mahajanpada. It is the fifth Mahajanpada, Virji. Contrary to the Magadha Empire, which had a hereditary monarch, Vajji was formed by an association of several clans. The most important of them was Lichavis. The capital of Vajji was Vaishali, Bihar, and it was under a different form of government, which was called Gana or Sangha. Gana is a group which has many members. Sangha is an organization or association. Gana means group and Sangha is association. These Gana or Sangha include many rulers, sometimes thousands. The rulers or the Rajas took their decisions together through discussion and debates. Means Gana is a group and Sangha is association. And so the rulers of that is Rajas, they took the decision through discussion among themselves, discussion and debates. For this, they met in assemblies, women and dasas and kamakaras, landless agricultural labors. Kamakaras are, who are kamakaras? They are landless agricultural laborers. Could not take part in this assemblies. So they were not allowed to take part in this assemblies where meetings used to take place between the rulers and association peoples. The rulers also performed their ritual together. The head of the assembly was known as the Ganaparamukh. Ganaparamukh. The head of the assembly was known as Ganaparamukh, whose position was not hereditary but as a chosen chief. Means the head of the assembly was known as a Ganaparamukh and he was hereditarily chosen as a chief. Means hereditarily means now next his son only will be chosen as a next chief. Both Lord Buddha and Lord Mahavira belonged to Sanghas, namely Sakya and Vajji. Means both Lord Buddha and Lord Mahavira, both the two great personalities belong to this Sangha name as Sakya and Vajji Mahajanpada.